All right, hello, wine drinking people. We are back finishing up what I drank yesterday, or pretty much last week. And man, we've got a lot more to cover before the year is over here. You know, even though we end in November, we've got probably some segments going into there just to finish up what we did in October. A lot of great suppliers in, like Donald Patz, who stops in at least once a year to see us. You know, I remember meeting Jason Hall 20 years ago at Honig Winery. They used to make their wine there. And that was the first time I knew anything about Patz and Hall, and we've been buying their wines ever since, making some of the best Chardonnay and Pinot Noir. That's all they do at Patz and Hall that you can find in California. Some of the greatest vineyard sites. And that's one of the things it takes to make great wines. You got to know where the good grapes are. You know, these guys, you know, very proficient at finding good juice. Let's just say that. All right, the Sonoma Coast, 2009 Chardonnay. Asian pear, kind of tropical fruit notes, a little creme brulee and lightly toasted oak spice there, cinnamon, nutmeg. Really nice complexity on the nose here. A nice creamy texture on the tongue with a nice concentration and balance. Just the right touch of toasty oak spice. Lovely freshness and a little vanilla kind of minerality showing there on the end as well. Excellent juice at just under $30. The Chardonnay Dutton Ranch. Well, you know, like I said, knowing where the good juice is, he gets some of the best grapes coming from Dutton Ranch, which is a huge vineyard. The Ruide section, it was planted in 1969, same year I was born. 25%, that's what 25% of this wine is made up of, and the rest is a blend of other Dutton Ranch vineyard sites. The old vines give this wine complexity, but, you know, it needs other things in order to make, you know, a great, well-balanced Chardonnay. But they do bottle a little bit of this for their mailing list only customers, and Donald says it's a little over the top for him. He likes this blend that goes in the Dutton Ranch better. All right, well, as I mentioned before, Dutton Ranch, a huge ranch, 1,300 acres under vine, 30 different sites on the Dutton Ranch. A nice amount of tree fruit on the nose here, peach and apple with roasted kind of nuts, and a hint of butterscotch as well. Very seductive bouquet. Really exotic, and a nice amount of oak here, but a lot of everything else as well. And a lovely backbone of acidity, lovely creamy texture here, and all that nuance and spice showing through on the finish. Most excellent. One of the best Chardonnays that I have had so far from the 2009 vintage. All right, the 2008 Hyde. This is a vineyard that's all planted to Wente clone, and a very exotic bouquet here, creme brulee, vanilla bean spice, the Asian pear, and ripe delicious apple fruit. Really seductive bouquet, a very rich style with a nice creamy texture of whole milk, and a good hand of oak spice here, but again, still lovely balance, lots of everything else here, lovely acidity, cleaning things up on the finish, a big wine, but lovely balance, most excellent juice again. All right, well, coming up next, the Pinot Noirs. And the 2009 Sonoma Coast, unfortunately, is not going to be around for long. You know, these guys are going to be released in 2010, I think before the end of the year. And, you know, I told Donald, maybe you need to raise your price. Your wines are selling too quick. Did I say that? Don't ever tell a producer to raise your price, because they will. All right, well, very short 2008, another reason why the 2009 was released so early, but really jammy style of Pinot Noir. I call this a Pinot Noir for Cabernet lovers. Black cherry jam-like fruit, a good hand of floral spice, a really pretty and seductive bouquet here. A big Pinot Noir on the palate, but you know, these wines all have got good palates, even though they've got a lot of fruit. There's lovely acidity cleaning things up here at the end, and a lovely savory note and a lovely spice as well here. Really excellent bottle of Pinot Noir for $33. All right, the Chenoweth Ranch in the Russian River. A little bit of smoke here to this wine. Not smoky from the fires, okay? Did I say that already once in this review? Okay, 2008 was marked with fire, and, you know, Donald said that they did have some issues up in their Mendocino vineyards with fire as well in 2008, but not in this wine, just a little smokiness, the natural thing you get from Pinot. Nice bit of spice, kind of green tea, exotic spice here shown as well, raspberry and strawberry-like fruits. Lovely spice on the palate to this light red berry fruit, and a nice zestiness to these wines. You know, even though they're unmistakably California because of their fruit, they all have got great balance, and I think you could keep these wines 8-10 years easily. Most excellent juice, this Chenoweth Pinot Noir from Russian River. Next up, the Alder Springs, oftentimes my favorite Pinot Noir, 2007. And this is up on the side of a mountain, 2,100 to 3,000 feet up marine soils. And he would say it's a double A site for Chardonnay and a double A site for Syrah, just an A site for Pinot Noir. But man, I'll tell you, excellent Pinot Noir. Like I said, oftentimes my favorite wine from them. If it was in Sonoma, it would probably be the most famous vineyard site in Sonoma, Donald says. And the grower, just very meticulous about how he keeps this vineyard. Red cherry pie-like fruit on the nose, a nice touch of spice, oriental, and rose petals. Very seductive and very smooth and silky wine on the tongue. The lovely amount of brown spice. Still has great freshness, long finish. This 2007, a ways to go. Most excellent juice. How many most excellent ratings can you get in a row, Don? I don't know, but man, the wine's all showing really good on this day. The 2008 Hyde Pinot up next. Black raspberry-like fruit on the nose, some pretty floral nuance as well as some exotic spices, red licorice, and a slight bacon fat kind of aroma. And this one in also a nice meaty Pinot Noir on the tongue, but still smooth and velvety. A good grip, though, and firm acidity. Nice hand of exotic spices on the finish. 15.2% on the octane scale, but nice balance. And you guessed it, still a zesty finish. Most excellent. Again, Pisoni Vineyard. Hey, this is my favorite Pinot Noir in California and has been my best pick several times. The 2008 Killer Juice. This is one of the greatest vineyard sites in all of California, located in the Santa Lucia Highlands area of Monterey. And just the spice in this wine, just so exotic and, you know, fills the glass. And black raspberry, black cherry fruit, lots of that pretty floral nuance, really meaty. Pinot Noir here, mouth-filling Pinot with just layers of spice, floral aroma, and the juicy fruit here, and the distinct minerality, too, to these wines from the Pisoni Vineyard. But, man, the focus here is on this ripe, jammy black cherry, black raspberry fruit, this lovely, velvety, sick, silky texture on the tongue, and a long, drawn-out finish. Killer juice, the Pisoni, my pick for best Pinot Noir coming from California again this year. Excellent juice, Donald. That's what I had to drink yesterday. I'm your host, Andrew Lampisoni, signing off for the Wine Watch, saying remember, always drink the good stuff first.